Hi there, and thank you for tuning in. A few weeks back, I made a video about shooting with this little camera, the Nikon Z50, in combination with the long lens, the 200 to 500mm 5.6. And in that video, I actually made a mistake, and I want to fix that mistake today. And thank you to Nick for helping me out. But I will come back to what actually the issue was and why I went wrong. But let's start out seeing the part where I, in the last video, defined what it is I want to achieve, because that part is actually okay. It's short. When I'm out shooting wildlife, I constantly flip-flop between two modes, I would say. One is where I'm trying to capture a bird on its wings or in motion here to the right, and another is when it's sitting very quiet here on a branch, sitting still. And the camera settings or the focus settings that I need for that, those two situations are very different. Up here, I want the focus mode to be continuous so that it continuously focuses, of course. I want it to look for the focus as wide as possible, and I want it to fire away. The release mode is a continuous high. On the other hand, when the bird is sitting very still, I want it to be, the release mode to be single frame, and I want it to pinpoint where the focus is, because I want to say it's right in the eye I want the focus to be. And then I want to have a single focus mode, because I want the focus confirmation to tell me you have acquired focus. I like the little beep that tells me now things are as they should be before I hit the shutter in full. So since I made the last video, I've changed my mind a little bit, in the sense that I want to have even more control by these two modes that I dream about to flip-flopping back and forth between. And one of the things, one of the additional things I want to control is the shutter speed, and also what semi-automatic mode I'm in. And I would like to be in shutter priority in both cases. So requirements have gone up a little bit, but still, I think it's a, you know, it's a good idea to have these modes to be able to flip-flop between. So let me just play the part where I go wrong. I do ask for help, actually, and Nikon, unfortunately, they didn't call me. But Nick helped me out. But let me just show you where I go wrong. So what I'm about to show you now, this is flat out wrong. Here it comes. Cannot really flip-flop between these two modes without having to push a lot of buttons. And if you have any ideas or suggestions how this can be done, I'm all ears. It would be wonderful, in case Nikon is listening, it would be wonderful if there was at least of those cameras that are dedicated for wildlife that were user, just like you have user 1 and user 2, there were two settings, so you could program or preset two focus settings and then just turn a switch. Yeah, that wasn't exactly my finest hour, because that is exactly what user 1 and user 2 does on the Nikon Z50. Let me show it how it works. And once again, I want to thank Nick for helping me out. Nick was kind enough to write to me and say that you know, user 1 and user 2 can do this. But I had actually misread the manual, and I will show you why I had, what it was I was struggling to understand, why I couldn't find what I was looking for in the manual. But let's shift to the overhead cam, as they say, in the expensive productions. I'll be right with you. So in order to make the camera a little bit easier to handle, when I show you this, I have removed the long lens and just installed the kit lens, the 16-50 here. But the principles are exactly the same. When you select user 1 and user 2, what actually happens is that it reads a lot of values from the memory banks associated with user 1 and user 2, and then sort of installs those in the camera that are then the current values. And the way you update user 1 and user 2, that's where I went wrong, because I thought you needed to be in user 1 and user 2 to update the value. So for instance, if you were in user 1, and you said here now you have the shutter speed is 1/250th. If you then change that to 1/160th, then my understanding, very wrong, was that then that value would be stored as part of user 1, because I was in user 1. But the fact is, when I actually, if I change the value to 160, leave user 1 and come back again, then it reads the value that was stored there. And that's because user 1 and user 2, the changes you do, as soon as you leave those modes, the changes you have done to those modes, they're actually gone. So what you need to do in order to update user 1 and user 2 is to go to the wrench menu. That's the one here that looks like a wrench. It's actually officially called the setup menu. And in the very first page, you have save user settings, user 1 and user 2. And what that does is it updates the values stored under user 1 and user 2, irrespective of which mode you're in or whatever is the situation. It takes all the values, relevant values from the camera, and stores them under user 1. And that means, for instance, and this is what really I didn't really understand, because I couldn't figure out how do I select when I'm in user 1, how do I then, for instance, select shutter priority? And the way you do that is that you set the camera in shutter priority mode, and then you go into the menu system and say save user setting, because then it will, under user 1, save shutter priority. It will also store all the other values that are current in the camera. I'm not sure exactly specifically what values it is that it stores, but it's a lot. And you can probably read that in the manual. It's around page 82 in case you're interested. But otherwise, I would just say give it a try and see if it updates the value you're after updating. But that's what really fooled me. How do I select a mode when I'm in user 1? And actually, the way you do that is actually go to the mode that you want and then go into the menu system and store it. So let's just see how I have set up these two modes, user 1. You may recall the user 1 was the one where I wanted to shoot a bird on a branch. And if I just show you here how that has been set up, I always shoot in RAW, just out of habit. Then I set the release mode to low. And that's because continuous low, that is, that's because I don't want to fill my memory card, and not that much action actually happens when a bird sits on a branch. But sometimes you'll be surprised that you come home with keepers just because you have a little bit of continuation going on here. The other thing I have is the autofocus area mode, where I've taken single point, and that's because I want to say it's exactly here I want focus, especially if the bird is sitting behind branches. Then it's a great thing to actually be able to pinpoint it's exactly here that I want the focus to be. And then finally I have continuous autofocus mode, and that is because I have taken the advice from Steve Perry that many changes can happen. You can move the camera, you can move the subject can move just a little bit. So if you take only one focus, single focus, and it's a moving subject, then you actually at risk that you the focus is slightly off as a consequence of that. So he actually suggests you always shoot in continuous autofocus. So I have adopted that advice, and it actually works quite well for me. If I go to and look at the shutter speed, I've set that to 1/250. I should mention that I'm in shutter priority mode. So I leave the camera decide the aperture and the ISO. But I set it to 1/250. Maybe that's a little bit fast for a bird sitting on a branch, but then I can always adjust it. It's a good starting point, I think. And that's actually great. I'm going to just show you here again. Maybe I'm over-exaggerating this point, but if I'm now I'm in user 1, if I then go to some other mode and come back to user 1, you can see now it has set the shutter speed back to 250. So every time you go into user 1 and user 2, it actually reads the value stored there. So that's, I mean, that's the way it works. So maybe it's very logical, I just didn't get it right away. If I take user 2, you can see it says up here top left, it says user 2, and I'm still in shutter priority mode, but now I can see I have a much faster shutter speed, and that's because I want to catch the bird in flight, so I need more speed on the shutter. And if I want even more speed, then I can quickly turn the rear command dial to get more. But I think 1250 is a good starting point, and in many cases it works, only if you have a bird that sort of flaps with its wings very fast, then you need to go to more than 1250, in my experience. If you go and look at the settings here, I'm continuous to be in continuous, so to speak. In terms of autofocus area mode, I take the full plate because I need all the help I can get, because I don't know exactly where in the frame the bird will be. I'm release mode, I continuous high because, you know, I need to fire a lot to just get a few keepers. And that's actually it. I stay in RAW. And in case you're curious what metering mode I use, I always shoot in matrix metering. That works for me. So there you have it. That's how I have set up user 1 and user 2. There are probably many more values you can set up, but try and play with this. But remember that the mode that you select here, the way you change the mode under user 1 and user 2 is to select the mode that you want and then affect all the values that you want, and then go into the menu system, say save user setting, and select either user 1 and user 2. That's the way it works. Not so complicated when you know it, but for sure it was complicated for me because I didn't really understand how it worked. So I hope this was helpful. Okay, so there you have it. I hope my explanation of user 1 and user 2 wasn't too complicated, and that you saw how you can use it to control camera settings, actually quite many camera settings. So I now, when I'm out shooting, use exactly user 1 and user 2 for wildlife photography, and it works quite well. I will say, like the Georgia photographer, if you follow him, the Z50 relative to other cameras, say Nikon D4 for instance, is a little bit slow in the beginning to focus, but otherwise I would say this combo here with the Z50 and the long lens 200 to 500 and the crop factor that gives this effect that you go up to 750 millimeters, it's great for shooting birds, and I will for sure make more videos about this, so stay tuned. As always, thank you for watching. Take care. Bye bye.